Hello students, welcome to the lecture on career planning and succession planning. And after the lecture, we will be able to learn the following objectives. Define the concept of career, understand the career planning, discuss the need for career planning, explain the succession planning, describe replacement charts. Let's start with a brief introduction to career planning and succession planning. Planning a career is the basis of a successful professional, although in today's day and age, there are several people who prefer to just go with the flow and avoid planning because things may not go as planned. However, when it comes to something as important as our career, planning it well with timely objectives would make us better prepared for our professional career graphs. Career planning includes the task of laying down objectives and timelines within which to achieve them, planning one's post-graduation or specialization studies, planning job changes to get the maximum benefit out of it, industry pay hikes and salary growth, planning shifts to grow professionally and develop expertise in a certain area, etc. let's discuss the concept of career. A career is a sequence of positions held by a person during the course of a lifetime. It comprises of a series of work-related activities that provide continuity, order and meaning in a person's life. This is an objective view of a person's career. Features. Some of the important features of the term career may be stated thus. A career develops over time. It is the individual who ultimately must judge the success of his career. The important element in one's career is experiencing psychological success, which basically is feeling a sense of personal accomplishment and fulfillment. The typical career of a person today would probably include many different positions, transitions and organizations, more so than is in the past when employees were less mobile and organizations more stable as employers. Steps in career development systems. Steps in career development are given as define the need. To hit the bull's eye, we need to talk with employees to find out what's missing. Is it lack of perceived opportunity, not enough training, too little communication, diversity issues? Identify target groups. Focus on the employees we most want to keep. This helps us to get buy-in from all levels of management, which is important in building enthusiasm and gaining acceptance for the initiative. Tie the initiative to human resources systems and policies. Company policies and practices regarding application procedures for posted jobs, managers' ability to block internal movement, hiring from within, use of computer job or talent banks, training, tuition, reimbursement, use of pay systems that reward flexibility rather than hierarchy, and performance management all impact the career development initiative and should be synced with it. Tailor the initiative to fit the culture. Start with the pieces that the current culture will accept. If we are trying to change our culture to create more employee initiative, giving workers the tools to take charge is an important way to do it. Take a long-term approach with short-term payoffs. To build momentum, develop the program in stages. Begin by conducting a needs evaluation with a manager task force, then design and pilot a program, measure the results, spread the good word and gradually include more managers and employees. Redesign performance management system to make the process easier if necessary. Co-design with line management. The career development system, like the performance management system, should be owned by line management, not by human resources, if it is to be successful. Separate career management from performance appraisal. Keeping the two apart helps assure employees that the purpose of the program is to help them manage their careers and not to help their superiors manage them. Ensure top management support. This is the key to success with almost all initiatives. Collecting manager and employee comments from career management workshops and disseminating them to other managers and employees works quite well. Let's now talk about career planning. A career can be defined as a sequence of separate but related work activities that provides continuity, order and meaning in a person's life. Features of career planning. The following features of career planning have been developed. Career planning formally follows a bottom-up approach in which the process begins with the individuals, works upwards and ends with organizational intervention. It is not a one-time affair but an ongoing process by which an employee identifies the needs and also the methods to fulfill those needs on a regular basis. It aims at matching the individual's career goals with the opportunities available. It is a means of achieving employee progression and organizational efficiency and not an end in itself. It is a collective responsibility of both the individual employee and the organization. It is normally made in a dynamic environment where the changes in the demand for and the supply of labor, the characteristics of labor, technology, competitive conditions, and market strategies are rapid and often radical. Did you know that Roy's personality development theory, career development, was introduced in 1956? The objectives of career planning. The principal objectives of career planning are to secure the right person at the right time for the right job, to provide adequate career avenues to employees to higher levels of responsibilities, to strengthen the retention program of the organization, and to maintain a contented team of employees.
The reasons for their unhappiness may vary. They don't like their work schedule, a colleague in their office, or even their boss. Often these reasons are really a cover for an underlying dissatisfaction. The employee never gave thought to his or her career goals. Only when a person has clear, thought-out ideas about career goals does he or she get satisfaction from the job and progress faster. This presentation covers many examples for your career goals and objectives. Here's a sample list of some basic career goals that an employee should keep in mind. Number 1, growth in resources. Nowadays, people have to constantly upgrade and enhance their knowledge and resources. Upgrading one's knowledge and resources to grow as a professional is an important career goal to pursue. Number 2, the financial aspect. The financial aspect is also important. If you're underpaid, you'll become bitter and frustrated, manifested in your work. Therefore, another career goal is to be paid as much as the job position is worth to the company. Number 3, satisfaction. An important career goal should be to be satisfied with whatever you're doing. Don't stop experimenting, but make sure you're getting some satisfaction with whichever job you're doing. Number 4, new experiences. We spend almost 3/4 of our life in the professional world. Therefore, it's logical that we look to our professional lives not only to progress and get ahead in life, but also to learn new things and gain new experiences. Number 5, stability. Another important career goal that a person should look for is stability. Once you get into a stable company, you can concentrate on growing as an individual and a professional. Another important aspect of defining your career goals and objectives is having a career goal statement. What would you like to achieve at any given time frame? Here are some examples of career statements. Comprehensive growth. Growth is the most important career goal that an employee should look into. There's no limit to the growth of an individual in a job. In fact, even if you become a CEO, the next level of growth is becoming an entrepreneur or a proprietor. Growth doesn't happen overnight, though, and being diligent and dedicated to a job is part of growing. Management. Another example of a career goal statement is setting a time frame for becoming a manager or a leader. Once you've mastered your work, seek a pathway to become a leader in your organization. Second career. An advantage of a second career is that you become financially free and can therefore take certain risks in your job, which would otherwise not be taken. Risks are just opportunities in disguise, and it could be the risks may turn out to be very lucrative. Logical conclusion, a business. After all the years of experience and work in a profession and business, you might consider having a business of your own. Ultimately, owning your own business could be one of your career goals. Gaining expertise. Once your experience passes a certain level, you should be good enough to become a job consultant. Another career goal is to become so experienced that you could be hired as a consultant by other companies.
Career planning process. The career planning process generally involves the following steps. Identifying individual needs and aspirations. It is necessary to identify and communicate the career goals, aspirations, and career anchors of every employee because most individuals may not have a clear idea about these. Analyzing career opportunities. Once career aspirations and goals of employees are known, there is need to analyze various career opportunities available to offer under prevailing career paths in the organization. Identifying congruence and incongruence. At this stage, a mechanism for identifying congruence between the employee career aspirations and the organizational career system is developed. This helps to identify the specific area where mismatch or incongruence prevails. Action plans and periodic reviews. Alternative strategies and action plans for dealing with mismatch are formulated and implemented. Benefits of career planning. Career planning is a goal that wishes to accomplish in a specific occupation or field with a strategic plan to get. A career goal helps us make decisions and focus on the kind of work we want to do. It motivates us, directs, and helps us achieve what we want. A career goal could be a specific job such as a teacher or a clerk. Problem in career planning and development. Various problems in career planning are as mobility. Employees who prefer faster career advancements do not stay in one position and not even in a single organization. Career and family. Men and women who pursue their own careers have specific problems. Dual career family. These days, both the partners in the families have professional careers. Husband-wife pairs often experience conflicts because of their work and family responsibilities. The family members develop commitment to both careers. The word career planning sounds rather serious. Nevertheless, it is a necessity for the modern-day students that are on the threshold of their lives. Career choice in their lives is more or less irrevocable. Choosing a career or being sure of one's career goals is also important from the point of view of choosing the right course of study at important crossroads in one's life, like after passing the secondary examination, after passing the higher secondary examination, and after passing the graduation examination. Good career planning can lead to a successful and satisfying career. Those who do not plan their careers are usually stressed from working in fields they do not like, and students waste time and money pursuing educational areas in which they have no interest. The decisions we make about careers are critical to our sense of well-being. Difference between career planning and human resource planning. The important points of difference between career planning and human resource planning are as under. Inventory of skills. Human resource planning provides an inventory of skills and potentials available within an organization, but career planning determines who could be groomed for higher level assignments, where, when, and how. Information about HR, human resource planning provides information about the human resources available within the organization for expansion, growth, and technological innovations. But career planning only tells as to who could succeed in case of retirement, death, resignation, etc. of existing personnel. HR planning useful to career planning. Human resource planning facilitates career planning by providing the following information: an inventory of human resource, its needs, number, types, skill, etc., changes in the functions and the activities 2, 5 or 10 years hence, if not for a longer period, nature and the extent of behavioral changes required to meet manpower needs, availability of human resource within and outside the organization, training opportunities, training resources and training time. Psychometrics. A psychometrician measures and analyzes personality characteristics, intelligence, aptitude, and opinions. He also studies the viability of testing procedures, analyzes results, and develops new and improved testing techniques and approaches. Psychometricians are sometimes psychologists as well, but are also often employed in the fields of educational development or human resources. Now let's talk about the succession planning. Succession planning is a process whereby an organization ensures that employees are recruited and developed to fill each key role within the company. Develop employees for succession planning. To develop the employees we need for our succession plan, we use such practices as lateral moves, assignment to special projects, team leadership roles, and both internal and external training and development opportunities. Through our succession planning process, we also retain superior employees because they appreciate the time, attention, and the development that we are investing in them. Employees are motivated and engaged when they can see a career path for their continued growth and development. To effectively do succession planning in our organization, we must identify the organization's long-term goals. Change the name of the process to from succession planning to succession development. Plans do not develop anyone, only development experiences develop people. We see many companies put more effort and attention into the planning process than they do into the development process. Succession planning processes have lots to do with forms, charts, meetings, due dates, and checklists. They sometimes create a false sense that the planning process is an end in itself rather than a precursor to the real development. Many humans fall into the same trap regarding physical fitness. We have many fantastic plans in place to lose weight. Measures outcome. This change of emphasis is important for several reasons. First, executives pay attention to what gets measured and what gets rewarded. If leadership development is not enough of a priority for the company to establish goals and track progress against those goals, it will be very difficult to make any succession planning process work. Second, the act of engaging with senior executives to establish these goals will build support for succession planning and ownership for leadership development. Third, these results will help guide future efforts and mid-course corrections. Keep it simple. We sometimes find companies adding excessively complex assessment criteria to the succession planning process in an effort to improve the quality of the assessment. Some of these criteria are challenging even for behavioral scientists to assess, much less the average line manager. Stay realistic. The head of engineering is a high-performing leader who has the potential to be CEO. She has always been in an engineering role. If she had sales experience, she would be even more ready to be the CEO. Development plan is written to include a job move to be a head of sales. Features of succession planning. Although many business leaders recognize succession planning as a critical component in a company's long-term growth, many US organizations lack a robust and up-to-date plan for grooming or recruitment talent. Succession planning can help save a company time, money, and a huge headache caused by efforts to replace key individuals quickly. Identify the vulnerabilities. The first step in succession planning is identifying which organizational roles require a future plan. The obvious positions are typically in leadership, since these individuals bring a unique combination of skills and experience that are not easily replaced. However, those responsible for succession planning should not overlook other individuals whose departure from their jobs might cause disruption. Skills inventory. When a valued employee leaves, it can be an emotional and stressful time, which can cloud judgment. A critical feature of succession planning is creating a list of the skills, the knowledge, and the experience needed for the job before the individual leaves. Creating a talent pool. Attracting and retaining future talent is another aspect of preparing a company for the future. Some organizations direct management to identify rising stars, which are then selected for leadership training. Other companies encourage all employees to take a self-assessment. Training is offered based on the skills identified. Timing. Planning for a smooth transition takes time. Those responsible for preparing the organization for the future should start planning a few years in advance of known or expected departures. Difference between career planning and succession planning. To any of the professionals, career planning is the most important factor in his or her life, be it a self-employed or salaried professional, but career planning is equally important in all forms. Otherwise, it would result in huge number of resignations and thus increase attrition rate in the organization. What is the purpose? It helps us to create, design, implement, and evaluate succession planning scenarios. In career planning, employers can identify possible career goals and draw up career plans for the employees. The show must go on, thus succession planning is also used to find right people to fill unoccupied positions in the organization. What exactly is career planning? Career is nothing but a bunch of collection of jobs or positions, and it generally describes an applicable career path within the organizational structure. So, what is succession planning? Proper succession planning ensures that there is a continuous availability of qualified personnel so that the organization can run smoothly without disruption. In succession planning, employers select suitable potential successors for those vacant positions. Now let's explore the replacement charts. Replacement charts are a human resource forecasting technique that describes a firm's organization structure in terms of individuals who occupy various managerial and professional positions. For each position, the incumbent and potential replacements are identified along with information such as potential for advancement, experience or skills needed to qualify for next position, gender for age and diversity planning, and age only for retirement planning. Replacement charts should be computerized and provide a description of how vacancies can be filled by a firm's internal labor markets. They should be updated annually or when changes in strategic directions occur. Updates should be guided by ongoing assessments of potential replacements, matching their current knowledge, skills, abilities, and other characteristics against not only present position requirements, but also those needed to meet anticipated future needs of the position. Now, in the end, let us summarize what we have learned in this lecture. A career can be defined as a sequence of separate but related work activities that provides continuity, order, and meaning in a person's life. Career planning is making sure that the organization has the right people with the right skills at the right time. Succession planning is a process for identifying and developing internal people with the potential to fill key business leadership positions in the company. Replacement charts are a human resource forecasting technique that describes a firm's organization structure in terms of individuals who occupy various managerial and professional positions. Career planning normally follows a bottom-up approach in which the process begins with the individuals, works upwards, and ends with organizational intervention.